Anger Plan, Biz Plan helped the Shalatos, paid for the legal fees to go to the tax court and to the Court of Appeals. The Court of Appeals absolutely got this decision right. One of the most interesting, and I read maybe 100 cases a month, right up 50. This court said to the tax court, the first thing they did, the tax court said, Charlene isn't an employee. And the Court of Appeals said, well, we reverse that. Now, that doesn't mean that she is. It reverses the decision that she's not. Then they said, hey, judge, tax court judge, we don't want you to look at intention. We don't want you to make up rules. And he had no basis in court law, in regs, to come up with a decision that she was or was not an employee. Just didn't use any. Well, we know what employee versus independent contractor says. Use the common employee versus independent contractor. Common law on that. And by the way, and this is the most important part, you know that wages of $720 and the $15,000? Both of them are compensation. One's taxable, one's not taxable. You got to add those two together. Is that compensation reasonable? Just because it's not taxable doesn't mean you discount it. So now we've got a new case that we're going to, the Court of Appeals said, we're going to run this the proper way. So great win for the small businesses. What we don't have to do anymore, according to the Court of Appeals, is we don't have to dot our I's and cross our T's and be so terribly careful. The judge said, tax court judge says, you're just moving money from Charlene's pocket to Milo's pocket to one bib pocket to the other bib pocket in the farmer. And the court says, hey, this is a small business. That's how it's done. Why make them have two checking accounts when one's just sufficient? Oh, no. This is going to be a fun decision to teach this year and carry.